this episode, I'll show you how to create pans and zooms on a video clip. I'm Mark Spencer from RippleTraining.com. Welcome to Motion Magic, where you'll learn visual effects and motion graphics in under 5 minutes. Here I am in motion, and I have a video clip of this guy performing a trick on a skateboard. It was shot with a high-speed camera, so it plays quite slowly. In fact, I've actually sped it up for this tutorial to work a little faster. To get started, what I'm going to do is add a camera to the scene. So I'll go ahead and click the Add Camera icon here. We'll switch to 3D. And now we have a new camera in our scene. To animate the camera, I'm going to use a behavior to do so. If we go to the library and we go to behaviors, there are a set of camera behaviors here that are specific to cameras, but we're actually not going to use any of those. I'm going to go to the basic motion category, and I'm going to use this behavior called move. So what I'll do is drag it onto the camera. And then here in the mini timeline, I don't want it to last for so long. I'm going to have it start after he's about here. So I'll move the playhead and tap I to trim the start of the move behavior. And I'll move forward time a little bit later, about here, and tap O to trim the endpoint of this behavior. Now all we need to do is use this control in the middle of the canvas to determine where we want to move the camera. So I'm going to move over and down to focus on the skateboard, and then I'm going to drag on this blue dot, which is actually the Z arrow pointing right at us, to zoom into the shot. If you're shooting on 4K or ultra high definition video, you can zoom in and still produce something that is 720p or 1080p and not lose any resolution. So now I've done that, and I go back and play through that, we have a nice little move on that shot. Now in the heads-up display, I am going to make one change to the speed, which is constant right now, which means there's a very sudden movement in and a sudden stop. I'm going to change that to ease both. So now when we look at that move, we get a nice smooth move to zoom into the skateboard. And if I want to change it, I can reposition it any way that I'd like. And if I want to go a little faster or slower, I can trim it. So now I've got my first move established, but I want to do an additional move. So say at this point, I want to pan up to look at the skateboarder himself. So I'll select this first move behavior, press Command-C to copy, press Command-V to paste, then I'll press Shift left bracket, which will move the endpoint of this new behavior to my current playhead location. Then I'll press Shift-O to move my playhead to the end of this behavior, and in the canvas, I'll drag up to focus on the skateboarder. So now if we play that through, we zoom into the skateboard, we look up to the skateboarder, and let's add one more. So I'll press Command V to paste, Shift left bracket to move that move behavior over to the playhead position, Shift O to move the playhead to the end of the behavior, and this time I want to come back to our original position. So what I'll do is press F2 to go to the second tab of the inspector where our behaviors are. And at the top is our last behavior, move copy one. I'll just press the reset button to reset this back to 0, 0 for position. So now if we play from the beginning, we zoom in to look at the skateboard, we pan up to look at the skateboarder, and we pull out to reveal the full scene. Click the subscribe button below, and please leave us your comments and suggestions for future topics. Go to rippletraining.com for fast professional training on Final Cut Pro 10, Motion, and DaVinci Resolve from industry professionals.